I think from the time I hit the floor, I knew that I would never walk again. I couldn't see my legs, couldn't feel them. I just thought that I'd actually been cut in half. It was just a terrible, terrible feeling.
When I first was asked to go and see a psychologist, I was actually scared because I thought I was going nuts. I couldn't understand how I couldn't stop crying, but he explained that I was suffering from post-traumatic stress. When I talk like this about my accident, it's like talking about somebody else. I know it was me, but I find it very hard to understand. It's as if you're a part player in a play, main character in it, but you just don't understand the part you've played.
I can understand some people might change life, but it doesn't for me because that's the way I am. Oh, well, I miss work, yes, definitely, but yeah, I do, I miss work a lot. Moving about. Mending things and such like.
One short incident turns their whole life upside down. It is such a sudden event that they're not prepared for it, and it has a huge emotional and financial impact on the family for the rest of their lives. Could something have been done to avoid these accidents? And I tend to think, yes, they could.
As the words come out of the person's mouth that is telling you it, you don't really believe what he's saying. And you think you're going to come out of a dream, or they're only joking, they're going to break into a smile and go, no, I'm only joking. For a split second, I mean. Then suddenly it dawns on you what they're saying. The full reality of what they're saying is hitting you. It's terminal. There's no medical cure for it.
When I went to the coroner's court, I just wasn't prepared for them to read out all the details. To be honest, gruesome details of my son's injury. They even went into the weight of lung, liver, and even removal of the brain, which is all procedure for them. But for somebody like me who's never been to an inquest, it was devastating.
It was Friday afternoon on a large construction site. Some timber sheet materials had been stacked on a scaffold incorrectly. They slipped off the scaffold and unfortunately fell three stories. The person who was injured was in the wrong place at the wrong time. His leg was damaged below the knee and needed to be amputated. Health and safety executive obviously investigated it and we were prosecuted.
I just couldn't believe it because he was so strong. I was just invincible, and if he'd been in this room with us, he would have filled it with his personality. And you think, someone that strong, you couldn't snap it out, you couldn't just snuff it out like that. I can't describe the loss, because I cared for him so much, and I know he cared for me.
I'll always remember that it was a beautiful, beautiful sunny day. My daughter had visited with the grandchildren, and I just thought I couldn't be happier. And even now, I remember that feeling of total happiness until the phone call that Scott had had a fall on site. I phoned the hospital, and they eventually phoned me back and told me the bad news. And it's just something you'll never forget. Your life will never, ever be the same again. never be as happy as I was that Friday morning. He was a shining star. He used to make me laugh. And you just miss the joy.
Martin and people like him are the backbone of this country. They don't take anything from anybody for nothing. They just go out and try and earn a living and look after the families the best they can. And they deserve more. It shouldn't be happening. And I wish I couldn't do it.